And so today I'm going to be sharing about belonging.
今天我来跟大家分享这个主题叫做归属。
So when you look at the word belonging, it actually has a lot of meaning, even in English and Chinese.
当我们看到这个词归属的时候，无论是英文还是华文，都有很多的意义在后面。
So when you look at the word, it tells you the origin of what the sense of it is.
那这个词告诉我们说，我们到底属于哪里？
So if you think about home, every one of us has a way to decorate our place.
那我们想到家的时候，每个人在家里的布置的方式都不一样，对不对？
Especially you go to a homewarming, housewarming, and then you begin to see it's not just TV, sofa, dining table, and all.
当我们去到不同人家里面来祝贺的时候，会看到他们家的摆设都很不一样。
And you it's not just seeing things that they just put on the wall, pictures or some unique items in the shelf.
所以我们看到说他们并不是把那个家具随便摆设，墙上挂几张画而已啦。
There is a theme.
因为它的背后有一个主题。
There is a meaning.
有一个意义在后面。
And then when you look at it, right, if the family likes to congregate around the dining table, then you see the center of the focus is a dining table.
所以你知道每个家的客厅的那个餐桌都是聚集全家人的最中心的一个点。
And so most likely the family, they are all very round here.
所以多数的家人那个肚皮都圆圆的哈。
But if those who like to congregate around television because they love entertainment,
因为每一个家人在餐桌旁边，他们互相彼此交流分享的时候都非常的开心。
Yeah, those who like to watch TV, you can see the high qualities, high end TV equipments all around the TV.
那些家人喜欢看电视的、看韩剧的哈，他们就把家里那个电视屏幕做得大大的。
So if that's our family tells us, the way we design our home tells about us.
所以我们的家怎么样的摆设是什么样的一个风格，就告诉了这个家的主人大概是什么样的了。
I still remember a time when I first traveled to UK with my wife.
我记得第一次当我跟我的太太一起去英国的时候。
You must understand that I never travel out of Singapore unless it's for military.
那时候我是第一次离开新加坡出国。
So when I went to UK, I'm really a swaku, you know, I'm really lost.
当我去到英国第一次的时候，我真的是耍酷啊
！Think of, wow, very good at you.
我也不知道什么意思。
She's popping, I like her. Okay, so, now have you been to a strange place and then you are totally lost, do not know where to go?
所以你去到那里一个陌生的环境，完全不知道这个接下来要去哪里，非常的这个迷茫。
And the anxiety go very high.
然后我就非常的焦虑了。
You know, so it's the same way when we think about life.
所以同样的，我们来思考一下，人生也是这样。
If you think about life, I believe there is one way or another, one time or another, we feel a sense of loss.
那在我们的人生，在你的人生过程当中，很多时候可能是不是我们也会感觉到有一点点的迷茫
？And the Bible talk about when I was lost and then I'm found.
那圣经告诉我们说，以前我是迷失的，现在我被寻回了。
And so the word belonging.
所以这个词归属呢？
Give us a sense of feeling.
它给我们一种感受。
That we are important and part of the family.
也就是说，我们是这个家庭当中重要的一员。
So I'd like to say the candidates today, you are important to every one of us.
所以对于所有即将接受洗礼的新家人来说，你们是这个家庭当中很重要的一员。我们鼓励他们一下，哈利路亚。
You know, I see the whole setup is slightly lesser than the wedding.
所以我们看今天的这个跟一个婚礼是差不多的感觉了。
You can see all the staff worker, all the members of the church running around trying to get things ready.
所以你看到我们所有的同工忙忙碌碌上上下下，就是为了预备今天的这场婚礼啊。
Because you belong to the family and we love you.
因为你们属于这个家庭，你们是重要的一员。
And in belonging tells about a close relationship.
那这个归属，它其实告诉我们是一个非常亲密的关系。
It's not like I grow up in Bukit Ho Swee, then I feel a sense of belonging in Bukit Ho Swee.
Bukit Ho Swee
我小时候长大。
It's
a kampung. So, you know,
就好像我不是出去随便只在街上遇到一个人，都会跟他有这样建立一个非常亲密的关系。
And Bukit Ho Swee has a huge memory for me.
Bukit Ho Swee 有一个非常重要的意义对我来说。
When I went there, I feel a sense of affinity.
当我去到那里，我就觉得好像有一个很亲切的感觉。
But the truth is, my childhood friend is no longer there.
但是我儿时的伙伴已经不在那里了。
So belonging.Also, not just affinity to a place, it's about affinity to a community.
所以这个归属感，它不只是说对某一些人，而是我们对于某一个群体有一种归属性。
And in the deeper sense, that community has a sense of commitment for one another.
当然，这个归属呢，也是在一个群体当中，我们有一个委身。
And you know, Chinese has a Hokkien saying that 树倒老高爽。哇。树倒猴子跑掉。
树倒猢狲散。
Is it true? Is it true?
Is it true? 华语里面我们有一句叫树倒猢狲散呐。
对对对。 I remember my grandma said this to me when she was very old.
当我的这个祖母告诉我这件事情的时候，她已经很老了。
Our families are bound together because we share the surname Day.
因为我们全家人在一起，是因为我们的这个姓都是一样的。
But in reality, my grandma knew the commitment is not there.
那我知道呢，我的祖母她知道，我们其实每个人并没有完全的就是心没有完全归属在这个家。
And the thing is, my grandma knew, and she got it right.
那她也做得很对。
Because when she passed away and my grandpa passed away, 树倒老高松啊。
所以当我的这个祖母跟祖父他们过世之后，真的就是树倒猢狲散了。
But not so in the people of God.
但是对于神的家当中
yes.
我们不是这样的。
And the Chinese word have a 归 is like a returning.
那这个归属的归呢，就是回来的意思。
And 属 is like a belonging. I belong or 属于 I belong.
属归属的属就是 belonging, 属于某一个部分。
And as we look at it, we really belong to God.
那我们在这样看的时候，其实每一个人在这里，我们都属于上帝的家。
When God turned our life from a sense of loss, He found us and established us.
当我们在人生当中觉得很迷失的时候，是神找到了我们每一位，把我们带回到他的家中。
And it is because we belong to Him, He bring us back home.
因为我们是属于他的，所以上帝因为爱把我们带回他的家。
And the Bible says this.In John 1:12-13,
在这个约翰福音的第一章
，It marks the beginning of the returning.
这个其实就是我们怎么样的归属。
And all the brothers and sisters in Christ who has received Jesus has this story.
所以我们每一位相信耶稣基督的弟兄姐妹们，我们都有这样的一个故事。
And he says this, but to all who did receive him, who believe in his name, he gave the rights to become children of God.
那这里说，凡接受他的就是耶稣基督，就是信他名的人，他就赐给他们权柄，成为神。
That is powerful.
这是非常有能力的。
You know, if just think about it. If you are son of the prime minister,
你想想看，如果你是总统的儿子
，and you went in, 总统 okay, president. So you went to the Istana, right?
你去到 Istana 里面的时候
，you are free to walk, right?
你进到总统府，你是非常自由的，可以
在里面穿行的。When the guard see you, the guard salute to you.
当那个门卫看到你，都要这样子的，对不对？
你要看我，要看我的老爹。
Yeah, you look at me and look at my father.
There is a power when we Bible says that we have the right to become a children of God.
因为我们是有这个权利的，当我们成为神的儿女的时候。
Because he said that he's the creator of heaven and earth.
因为我们是神的创造。
And all things belong to him.
因为所有的一切都属于上帝。
And you know that how blessed for us to have God come into our life.
你知道我们有神在我们的当中，在我们的生命当中是多么有福的一件事情吗？
And Romans 12 talk about that they use the descriptions of belonging, talking about the body.
所以在罗马书里面告诉我们这样一个肢体来形容。
Body has many parts, many functions.
因为这个肢体里面有很多不同的部分。
And every functions work for one purpose.
那每一个肢体都有一个不同的功能。
And so is the family of God.
那在这个神的家中也是这样。
That everyone are gifted with different gifts.
每一个人的恩赐都不一样。
And different personalities.
每个人的性格也不一样。
But for only one single purpose.
但是我们只有一个目的。
That is to love God and love one another.
就是我们要爱神并且爱人如己。
And that commitments for the community of God test the test of time.
所以当我们在一起来互相彼此相爱的时候，让这个世界认识我们是神的儿女了。
And so today we have the beautiful seven of them.
那今天我们有。
And Hanson.
八位哈，非常
八位哦，八位，
八位哎，八位，好，帅哥美女在我们的当中。
Right, so later on when they go for the baptism, as they publicly declare the conviction of their inward faith, we want to cheer for them.
所以当他们等一下接受洗礼的时候，我们每一个人在场的，我们一起欢喜快乐的，好不好
？And the cheering is not just today.
今天不只是今天而已啊。
But cheering is for the rest of their life.
而是他们接下来每一天的生命，我们都要与他们同行。
As the saying goes, it takes a village to raise a child.
所以我们都知道，要来培养一个孩子成熟，是要整村的人一起来的。
So are you ready to cheer for them?
所以我们有没有预备好
？Yes, ah. So now I want to do something different, okay?
所以今天我要做点不一样的。
We have a Kallang wave, right?
我们有那个 Kallang wave 啊
，So we're gonna do Petra wave 啦。
我们来做 Petra wave。
Some time ago, Petra has a flooding, so no more flooding. So we're gonna do a Petra wave, okay? So let's start from here, okay?
我们从这里开始要做一个 Petra wave 啊。
My finger has power, not. Okay, so when I point at you, you wave. Can you do that?
好，我们这个手指指到你哪里的时候，你要这样子 wave， 要举起来。
Okay, so I want you all to stand up.
来，我们站起来。
I want you all to enjoy.
好，我们要一起来欢喜快乐。
No, you the seven of the eight of them.
啊，只是这个。City的
站起来。
请你们站起来。
Then 我要你向着他们。
哦，可以转过去来。
向他们啊。
转过去看着他们。
Okay, guys, are you ready?Okay, we're going to do the wave for them, okay?
好，我们一起来 wave 啊。
Okay, you all just enjoy, okay? You all just enjoy, we are cheering for you.
我们一起来欢喜快乐，来享受。
Okay, ready, one, two, go, starting from here, right, come on, okay, give yourself a round of applause, thank you.
好，来一起。
Okay, 可以坐下来了。
哈利路亚，感谢主。
And this is belonging, and we're going to cheer for you for the rest of your life.
这个就是归属，我们家人在一起，为你欢喜快乐，一起与你同行。
And the Bible describes God's people as a chosen people and a royal priesthood and a holy nation and a people belonging to God.
所以圣经里面告诉我们说，我们是一群蒙拣选的族群，是君尊的祭司，是圣洁的国度。
In other words, we who have God, we are marked with God.
也就是说，我们有神在我们的当中，我们是神的儿女，已经有了一个印记了。
I remember running an Alpha course.
我还记得之前我有办启发课程的时候。
And we were running the course to the Holy Spirit weekend.
啊，我们在做一个圣灵的一个聚会。
And then I remember this one sister who, has a religious commitment in the afternoon.
啊，那我记得这个姐妹她下午有一个另外一个聚会，也是宗教型的聚会。
And she told us that I can only be there in the morning.
啊，她就跟我们讲说早上她没有办法来。
早上来，but 下午I will be there in the morning. Afternoon I can't.
啊，早上来，下午不能来。
And so.So we just continue.
然后我们就继续。
She came, she received the message, she enjoyed herself.
然后她就领受了这个信息，她也非常享受。
And she left for her religious commitment.
然后她下午就去参加另外一个聚集了。
And the moment she arrived in that place,
当她去到那个地方的时候
，in the temple,
是在一个庙里面。
And there was this monk standing across.
然后她的这个对面就有一个和尚走来。
And she crossed the threshold and began to walk towards the monk.
然后她就向着那个和尚走过去。
And the monk saw her and called out to her.
然后那个和尚看到她就对她说。
And the monk said to her that there is a cross on your forehead.
哦，那个和尚就看到说啊，在你的头上有一个十字架。
And she was surprised.
啊，在你的前额有一个十字架，她觉得很惊讶。
How does he know?
她说这她怎么知道呢？
People of God, there's something called the spirit realm.
啊，所以弟兄姐妹知道吗？属灵界是很真实的。
And that her morning in the Alpha course, right, marked her life.
因为那天早上他参与的这样的一个聚会当中，他相信的神也就在他的这个生命当中有了一个印记，圣灵的印记。
And the Bible says this that He called us out of darkness into His wonderful light.
因为圣经告诉我们说是神把我们呼召出了黑暗，入了光明。
If you think of all the stories of how many of us accepted Christ, there is a time before Christ is when we live in darkness.
所以很多时候，当我们回想信主之前，我们的人生可能是生活在一片黑暗当中。
And you will hear the story, the testimony from Jesseline later on.
等一下，我们会有一个姐妹来分享她的生命见证。
And I believe that all of us will be blessed.
我知道每一个人都会受祝福的。
And this is what he says about Christ. He says that God showed His love for us.While we were still sinners.
那这里讲到圣经说，因为耶稣基督在我们还是罪人的时候就已经为我们的死，上帝的爱就此显明了。
And so in that sense, the our life stories of being saved is about because God first demonstrated His love.
那我们的人生，我们的生命可以被主来寻回，得着救恩，是因为上帝爱我们，先爱了我们。
It's not something that I wake up in the morning. Oh, I want to be a Christian.
不是说你突然间早上醒来，这个如梦初醒，说我要信耶稣基督了。
Every life has a process of seeking in the midst of loss.
在每一个人信主的过程当中，都是有一个过程的，他可能在寻找。
In the midst of finding when it's dark.
那在你在黑暗当中前行的时候，可能在寻求神。
And it's not surprising, Jesus says, "I am the way, the truth, and the life."
所以耶稣圣经里面讲，耶稣说，我就是道路、真理和生命。若不借着我，没有人能到父那里去。
And I know the love of God will seek out even for a person furthest away.
我也知道上帝一定会到世界的末端去寻找那失丧的人群。
I know of a story of a man living in the east, northeast of India.
我知道认识一个人，他是在印度的东北部。
And pretty close to Pakistan.
很离这个巴基斯坦非常的靠近。
He was brought up in a religious way.
他就是在一个宗教的环境当中长大的。
And he even memorized one third of the holy book.
他把他们这个宗教的这个书籍呢背了三分之一。
But when he began to see the things happening in the world, he began to be disillusioned.
那当他开始看到这个世界上的事情的时候，他觉得非常非常的困惑。
And that night, he turned to the sky and said, "If there is really one true God, then you reveal yourself to me."
有一天晚上，他向着夜空这样子去询问说：“上帝，如果你真的是存在，你是真神，请你向我来显现。
”And that very night, he encountered God.
就在那天晚上，他遇见了耶稣基督。
He saw himself drowning.
他看到他自己好像被水淹
and it was drowning. There's a white figure. There's a white man came down and held his hand and lift him up.
让他看他自己在淹水快要沉下去的时候，有一个人穿着白色的袍，伸出手来把他救拔出来
And he began and he knew in his heart that that man is Isa.
在他的心里面，他认识，他知道这个救他的人就是耶稣基督
And from that on, for 2 years, he searched throughout the world in the internet.Talking to various people in the world about Jesus Christ.
然后之后呢，他两年内就在到处去寻找，上网寻找，到处去问耶稣基督到底是谁。
And one fine day, he arrived at my church.
有一天他突然来到了我的教会。
That's when I was in Barker Road Methodist Church.
以前我在这个卫理公会的时候，他就突然间走到我们的教会来。
Security is very tight.
因为那个安全措施非常的紧。
Because important people's children are in the school.
因为在那个教会当中，很多重要人物的孩子都在那里。
I even see one girl has a one personal bodyguard.
那我看到一个孩子进来的时候，他背后有一个保镖跟着他进来。
I do not know how he get in. He weaved his way through the crowd, and it was like 12 o'clock and 1 o'clock-ish at dismissal time. He weaved his way and went to the security counter, and there is a front door, front gate security and the inner security.
当时的这个保安措施非常的严格哈，但是这个人不懂他怎么样钻进来的啊，第一关、第二关、第三关，他全部都过来了。
And he managed to get it through.
他进来了，居然。
So security fail.
保安失败。
He went to the security counter and talked to an Indian lady, which I know, and says, "I want to find Jesus."
然后他就对这个保安说，我要找耶稣基督。
And the dear sister is also fellow Indian. You want to find Jesus, nah?
然后这个保安这个姐妹就说你要找耶稣啊。
So she take the sticker and put on him and said, "Jesus, fourth floor."
然后这个印度籍的保安就告诉给他一个 sticker 放在这边说耶稣四楼。
And when he went up to the off church reception, the receptionist, we bless her. Pastor Malcolm really love people. And so he hired a very grouchy looking receptionist.
所以他就进来，透过这些这个 reception， 然后就进到我们的聚会当中。
Yeah, so he went to Mary, and Mary was very grouchy, and the Indian man looked at him and said, "I want to find Jesus."
然后这个印度籍的弟兄进来，看到这个 receptionist， 然后他就说，我要找耶稣基督。
Mary in the grouchy face came to me and say.Indian man want to look for Jesus.
然后这个 reception 就告诉我说有一个印度人来要找耶稣基督。
So being comical, I look at my pocket, I look at that, and I say, "I didn't know we had lost Jesus."
然后我就跟他开玩笑，我说：“我们好像没有把耶稣忘记呀。”
Fast forward.
然后继续前进。
I begin to present the gospel. I talk about Adam, Abraham, David, Jesus.
然后我就跟他来分享整本圣经当中关于福音的信息。
And every time he stopped me and said, "When can I believe Jesus?"
然后每次他看到我说，都说我什么时候可以相信耶稣基督
？Because I didn't know the 2 year search.
因为我不知道他之前已经寻找了两年的时间。
Finally, after 1 hour, I reached Jesus.
我跟他解释了一个小时，最终来到了耶稣基督。
Because I want him to know the real Jesus.
因为我想他认识真正的认识耶稣基督是谁。
And he accepted Christ.
然后他就在那个时刻接受了主。
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Do you know the first thing he did when he became a Christian?
当他成为基督徒之后，他第一件事情做了什么？你知道吗
？Can I have the Bible?
我可以有一本圣经吗
？Then I was like, "Why you want to have Bible now?"
我说你为什么现在要圣经呢
？No, the small book is good to help you start, you know.
我就给他一个很小的一手册，我说这个你开始读就够了。
And he said this to me. My family know him because we brought him home, Samuel. He says, "I have memorized my holy book. I want to memorize the Bible."
Wow.他说我以前的这个宗教我已经把三分之一都背记下来了现在圣经我要背下来至少三分之一
And this is the heart of God in 1 Timothy 2
这就是圣经当中告诉我们的
And it says that God our Savior who desire all people
因为神他渴望每一个人都来得救
All type of people
所有无论种族文化什么背景的
Yes, all ages, all culture, all background He want all people to be saved
所有的人无论什么样的肤色种族的神希望每个人万人都得救
And to come to the knowledge of truth
而且要认识真理
Darkness to light, how do we enter into light is when we begin to encounter GodEncounter Jesus and His truth.
我们怎么样的从黑暗入光明呢？就是当我们遇见耶稣基督的时候。
And he says that Jesus is one mediator between God and man.
这里告诉我们说，因为神只有一位，在神和人中间也有一位中保。
And he gave himself as a ransom.
也就是耶稣基督，他把他自己成为众人的赎价。
You see, the problem of all men and the problem of the world is that sin is at work.
因为我们 这世界上所有的人都面对一个问题，就是罪的问题。
But you know what? That God loves us.
因为神爱我们。
But God gave us the free will.
但是上帝给了我们自由意志。
And in our free will, we act according to our ways.
所以按照我们的自由意志，神也允许我们自己来做出选择。
And because of that, the world is in conflict and pain.
所以因为这样的缘故，这个世人，世界上的人，很多人都在这个痛苦当中挣扎。
So I'd like to get a few of everyone. Have any one of you hurt by people before? Raise your hand.
在我们当中有没有之前被别人伤害过的？
Has anyone been hurt by people before?
有没有曾经被别人伤害过的？
Have been disappointed by people before?
或者你觉得对别人失望过的？
People betray you before?
或者背叛你的？
And lie to you before?
向你撒谎的？
And worst case, have beaten you before?
甚至是什么杀人的？
没有没有被打。I think Ian Toh will talk about his gangster background.
Okay.
So the thing is.We live in the painful world.
这事实是我们都知道，每个人我们生活在这世界上有经历很多的痛苦。
You know what? Because sin set a separation between us and God.
因为罪使我们跟神之间隔绝了。
And because of that, Jesus came.
也因为如此，耶稣基督才要来到这个世界。
To redeem us.
来成为我们的赎价。
Can you turn to your neighbor?
跟你旁边的说。
And say Jesus redeem you.
因为耶稣救赎了你。耶稣救赎了你。
And so the baptism talk about a powerful story.
所以当我们每次洗礼的时候，都有非常棒的这个很有能力的见证。
This is not a case where we want to go pong, you know.
我们今天不是来游泳的哈。
Because the Bible is, Bible Jesus commanded us.
因为耶稣基督已经邀请了我们。
And it is a powerful symbolism of life before and life after.
这个其实是一个非常重要的一个象征性的意义，代表着我们之前的生命跟之后的生命。
Because life before we are dead in sin.
因为在我们信主之前的生命，我们是死在死的状态当中。
And just as when a person go into the water.
当我们进入到这个水里面的时候。
And I know Pastor Tiha, me and Pastor Ray, we are very kind. We won't hold you for 10 minutes.
所以你们不用担心，我们不会让你闷气十分钟。
But the reality is, if we go inside the water for too long.We will die, right? It's a symbolism of death.
我们今天做的这个动作是一个象征性的。
And the same way, when we come from outside to here, Singapore is very dusty and dirty. We carry dirt in our body.
同样的，当我们从外面进来，其实我们的身上有很多一些的污秽。
And a symbolism of sin, right?
也就是我们生命当中的罪。
And when the moment we go in and we come out, we are cleansed.
当我们进入到水里面被水埋葬，然后再出来，其实一个象征性的，我们里面的罪要死掉。
And the Bible says the old has gone and the new has come.
因为圣经告诉我们说，这旧事已过，新的都来了。
And so when later when we cheer for them, every one of them go down and come out, right? When they come out, we want to cheer for them.
好，所以等一下我们洗礼的时候，每一个人进去起来的时候，我们都要一起来欢喜快乐。
Because it's a powerful declaration.
因为这是一个非常有能力的宣告。
It's a prophetic act.
这是一个先知性的宣告。
That the old life has gone.
因为过去以往的这个生命要过去了。
The old sinful self is gone.
以往的这个旧人要死掉。
Because the new self.
因为新的创造，新的生命要起来。
In Jesus Christ.
要复活了，在耶稣基督里面。哈利路亚。
Amen. Amen.
感谢主。
So the significance of salvation, because Christ who lives in me, and I have been crucified with Christ, and I no longer live, but Christ who lives in me. The life I live now in the flesh, I live by faith in the Son of God who loved me.And gave himself for me.
所以我们知道这个救恩的意义，就是当我们与耶稣基督一同被钉在十字架上，现在活着的不再是我，而是什么呢？耶稣基督活在我里面。我如今是在肉身中的生命，是靠信上帝的儿子来活着的，因为他爱我，为我舍命。
So in other words, there is a spiritual death.
也就是说，我们有一个属灵的死亡。
And there will be a spiritual life for you.
同样，我们有一个属灵的复活。
And so the significance of baptism tells us that we are buried.Into the baptism of death.
那这个洗礼的意义告诉我们说，其实是我们与耶稣基督一同死亡。
And Christ was raised from the dead through the glory of the Father, so that we might walk in the newness of life.
因为耶稣基督他替我们死了，我们是借着洗礼跟他一同埋葬，为要行事为人有新生命的样式，是正如基督借着父的荣耀从死里复活一样。
And so the Bible says, anyone is in Christ, he's a new creation.
圣经告诉我们，若有人在基督里，他就是一个新造的人了。
It's possible for a person to be transformed. change.
也就是说，在圣灵里面，我们的生命是可以不断更新而变化的。
Can you turn to your neighbor? It's possible.
啊，跟你旁边人说，你的生命会变，会改变的。
If you're Hokkien, you turn to your neighbor and say, 唔样诶。啊，
福建话唔样诶。
I remember I brought my dad from the hospital when he had TB and back home, and my fourth uncle was with me.
我记得当我的爸爸这个洗礼的时候，我的叔叔跟我们一起。
And my fourth uncle knew my life.
那我第四个叔叔他知道我的生命。
Because in the past I lived in a life without Christ, full of pain and anger.
因为我在以前没有信主的时候，我的生命里充满了痛苦，很有这个很多的愤怒。
And even rage.
甚至是真的是非常的怒气冲天。
I remember a time when I was so angry that I wanted to hit my sister, but I knew I can't hit my sister, so I kicked the chair.
那因为有一次我非常的生气，我想要打我的妹妹，可是我不能打她，我就这个一直打这个踢这个椅子。
And the chair fell apart.
那个椅子就坏了。
I don't learn kung fu. I didn't do anything, but it just fell apart. And I got a shock because it was like I saw the violence and the destructiveness of rage.
然后当时我就非常的害怕，我看到我里面那个怒气是会带来多么大的一个伤害。
And as a kid, I don't like people to talk about my family.
小的时候我不喜欢别人来谈论我的家。
Because my dad is an alcoholic.
因为我的父亲酗酒。
And he's a drug addict.
然后又这个吸毒。
My mom is a gambler.
然后我妈妈又这个赌博。
And there's no peace day and night. Loan shark come to our house and bang bang bang, right?
所以我家根本没有平安，整天有人敲门，当当当要来还债。
So I remember I was in a car with my fourth auntie and she was talking about my family.
当时我的一个阿姨就跟我来谈家里的事情。
And I was so angry.
我非常的生气。
And I still remember it was at Holland Road. It was moving. I opened the door and I jumped.
然后当时我就真的是想把门这个打开就跳
出去。It was that impulsiveness and the anger that's inside me that controlled me.
因为当时我里面真的是有一种冲动，一种愤怒无法控制的。
Praise be to God.
然后感谢神的是。
Because change is possible.
因为改变是可能的。
Because when my fourth uncle brought my dad home from the hospital, he turned to me and said this.
当时我的那个叔叔就把父亲带回家，他对我说。
He said, 阿星啊。
阿星啊。
我叫阿星啊。
阿星，
你说阿星啊，司职哇，冇想到啲嘢变咗咁嘴。
哇。
He has not imagined that I changed so much because of what I did as a kid.
因为他看到我的成长的背景，他知道我以前是怎样，所以他看到我的生命有这么大的改变。
And then he was so shocked. And then 阿星啊，我司职冇想到你变咗博士。
你们都明白了对吧？
He was so shocked. This boy from Bukit Ho Swee and then become a pastor.
然后他就非常的惊讶，这个孩子以前是这个样子，这么多的这个问题，这么愤怒，居然现在成为一个牧师了。
And then I married an Amor.
然后我又娶了一个阿摩太太。
So they blow their mind. They say, "Wow, this God doesn't know what is amazing."
然后他们简直无法相信，这个神简直太奇妙了。
So anyone who repents to Jesus is a new creation.
每一个人愿意回转向神的，都会成为一个新的创造。
Even for our newcomers or for those among us who have yet to receive Jesus, it's okay, no pressure.
所以如果你今天新来的，你还不认识耶稣基督，没有关系，不用压力。
You know, a lot of people think Christian like to force you to believe, right? No, I don't do that.
有些人会觉得基督徒或者去教会，他们都好像要强迫你要做什么。我们不会的，放心。
But the thing is, if you have a desire.Then follow that desire.
如果你里面心中有一个渴望，想要更多认识神，来跟随你内心的那样一个感受。
And the Bible says that no matter what is your path, but your past, you will be forgiven.
因为圣经告诉我们是，无论你的过去是如何的，在耶稣基督里面都可以成新了，你的过去被原谅了。
No matter how you are under the bondage of sin, for whatever sin they may be, you will be free.
无论你过去的罪是怎样，你所有的罪，你将会从这个罪中捆绑中被释放出来。
And you can have possible to live a new life and to have a new way of living.
你有这样一个可能，是你的生命是可以活出一个全新的生命。
Because the Bible says that He gave us a right to become children of God.
因为圣经告诉我们说，我们有这个权利成为上帝的儿女。
You know, in Hokkien, it says "Ti Bei Bo Bei."
Ti Bei Bo Bei.
You know, it's 天父的宝贝。
天父的宝，我们都是天父的宝贝。
Yeah, so you have the Creator, the Maker of heaven and earth with you. Who can be against you?
这个创造天地万物的主宰在你的里面，你还怕什么呢
？And you begin to see a renewed purpose in your life.
你会看到你的生命将有一个全新的意义。
Let me close with a few pointers for the baptism candidate and also, of course, the rest of us.
好，最后呢，我们也做一个这个结束，一个总结。
And the Bible talks about that we are people belonging to God.
圣经告诉我们说，我们是属于上帝的。
Nothing beats coming to our Father.
没有什么事情比回到天父的家更重要了。
I've seen many pre-believers come to know God.
我看到许许多多人他们生命改变成为基督徒。
And many of us, 老百姓 no, 老百罪。Everybody cry.
因为每一个人信主的时候，他的家人都会非常的欢喜快乐，会流泪的。
And when you receive God into your life, you experience His love and forgiveness.
或者是那些人在经历神、相信主的那一刻，他们都会流泪，因为他们感受到了神的爱。
And you will turn darkness to light in your life.
因为他们出了黑暗，进入到光明了。
Second is declaring.
第二个呢，就是我们要来宣扬。
Because he says that you may declare the praises of him who called you out of darkness.
也就是说，我们要来宣告我们已经宣扬上帝的美德，我们已经出了黑暗，入了光明。
And every one of you are declaring. Today.
每一个人，你们今天都会在众人的面前来宣告。
And the rest of us as a church family, we are declaring God's goodness in our life.
然后我们每一个人在座的，我们一起来宣告上帝的美德。
Not only salvation declaration, but it's also day to day living where we encounter God.
所以不只是救恩而已，而是我们每一天的生活、生命都要来宣扬上帝的美德。
And then we're going to walk.
然后我们要一起来在爱中行走。
Because you call you out of darkness into His light.
因为神呼召我们出了黑暗，入了光明。
That we cannot say we are the light and then we are living in darkness.
我们不能说我们进入到光明国度，可是我们的生活还是在黑暗当中。
Trust me, many of us experience this when we receive Jesus into our heart. Our heart suddenly become very soft.
很多时候我们发觉当我们信了主的那一刻起，我们的心开始变得非常的柔软。
Before we know Christ, our heart is very hard, you know?
在我们信主之前，我们的心可能里面是很刚硬的。
我恨你。
I hate you.
你是我的仇人。
You are my enemy.
Right? Yeah. But after hard, you cannot say I hate you already because 我爱你。 哎呦，哎，like that. Right?
After you change, your heart becomes soft. I love you.
And because our heart also becomes sensitized, that we become sensitive to sin.
因为我们的心变得很柔软的时候，我们对这个罪就变得越加的敏感了。
You will soon discover that the things that we always do that is wrong, suddenly we feel like, hey, this is something wrong here.
很多时候你会发觉信了主之后，有些东西以前你做的很习惯都无所谓，可是信主之后你觉得，哎，好像里面一个力量告诉你，一个声音告诉你这个不好，不要这样做。
I tell you a real joke, okay? As a teenager, I swear vulgarity like nobody's business. Really, really can score from this generation to the next 18 generation, you know.But then this side to that side, you know, boss your boss also can curse one, you know.
当我在信主之前，我告诉大家，我真的是很会骂人的，是他祖宗八代，我都会一个一个的就全部骂到完的。
So I have close friend, four of us, we are full of vulgarity, and then we accepted Christ.
然后我们四个哈一群来的哈，好像黑帮这样， yeah. 然后全部都信主了。
Yeah, at my 50th birthday they came. So we are so became so.Pricks in our conscience that we say we cannot score vulgarity anymore.
因为信主之后，我们的心变得柔软，我们知道不能像以前那样生活了。
Because life and death come on our tongue, right?
因为我们的舌头，生死在舌头拳下，对吧
？And so we say, okay, we're going to help each other not to score vulgarity.
然后我们就说我们要彼此帮助，不要再这样继续骂人了。
Whoever score vulgarity, the rest can slap.
我们就彼此四个人哈约定好，任何人开始骂的时候，另外三个人就打他一巴掌。
So that week, the whole week, our face very shine.
All our. 所以那一周是我们每个人脸上都放光啊，全部被删了很多次。
But because we desire to walk from the out of darkness into light.
因为我们决定了我们要离开这个黑暗，不再在这个黑暗当中生活了。
And we knew that as a life in Christ, I cannot live in sin.
因为我们如果有耶稣基督在我们里面，我们不可以继续活在这个罪中。
Because the last but not least.Is love.
但是最后最重要的就是爱。
Love one another as I have loved you.
圣经告诉我们，我给你们一个新的命令，就是你们要彼此相爱。
And that is the command of our Lord Jesus.
这就是耶稣基督给他的门徒的一个新的命令。
And I pray the Lord will fill your heart with so much love that every pore of your skin will ooze out love.
我要祷告神的灵充满你们每一位，让上帝的爱在你们的生命当中彰显出来。
And I pray that love will mark your life.
我要祷告是神的爱要来在你们的生命当中做一个最重要的记号。
And so the Bible says the mark of a Christian. Can we read this together?
这是我们一起来讲，来读这段经文好吗？圣经所告诉我们。
So 你是讲华语的 Channel 8就读 Channel 8, okay? Channel 5, Channel 5, okay? If you are Channel 1, 12, don't know whatever, then you can read in your own.
好，所以我们等一下哈，无论你是 Channel 5, Channel 8, 随便怎么语言，你都一起来读 ，okay?
Okay, we're gonna read this together, okay? So don't ignore the rest, just read for yourself. You want to read for yourself, ready?
好，
我们一起来读哈。One, two, go. Let love be genuine. Abhor what is evil. Hold fast to what is good. Love one another with brotherly love. Outdo one another in showing honor. Do not be slothful in zeal. Be fervent in the spirit. And serve the Lord. Rejoice in hope. Be patient in tribulation. Be constant in prayer. And contribute to the needs of the saints. And to show hospitality. Everybody say amen. Come, let me pray, yeah?
好, 我们一起来祷告。
Father God, I just want to pray for everyone here.
主, 我们要一起为今天的家人来祷告。
Because in you, we are sealed with your love.
主, 因为你的爱, 我们每个人被神的爱来画了印记。
And because we are sealed in your love, we are bounded as a family.
因为神的爱, 我们每个人成为家人。
It's not just here on earth, but it's there in eternity.
不只是在地上而已, 而是在永恒当中, 也要成为家人。
And so Lord, I pray that God, you help us to love one another to eternity.
主, 帮助我们彼此相爱, 一直到永恒。
And I pray that your love will be the compass for us to lead our life.
主, 我们祷告你的爱, 神的爱, 将成为我们人生的指航。
And so Lord, I pray especially for the 8 of them.
主, 也为所有要即将洗礼的新家人来祷告。
As you say that you pour out your spirit into our hearts, and therefore we call you Abba Father.
主啊, 因为你的灵在我们的当中, 我们可以呼喊阿爸父。
And so Lord, I ask in the name of Jesus that you fill every single one of them.
主, 我们奉耶稣基督的名来, 求圣灵充满他们每一位。
With your Holy Spirit.
圣灵来充满他们。
And to work a mighty work in their hearts.
主啊, 在他们生命当中做一个翻转。
So that it will be marked by love.
让他们的生命是被神的爱来画上印记。
In Jesus' name.
奉耶稣的名祷告。
Amen.
Amen.